students, so in this session I am going to discuss you about some problems based on the unit 3, that is motion in a plane. So I have given the basic formulas that are required to solve today's problem. So make a note of this, a very basic diagram that you need, a vector diagram and the resolution of this vectors and the magnitude and the angle. Then next one is average velocity. So average velocity is total displacement divided by total time, and it is a vector quantity. And average speed, which is the total distance by total time, it's a scalar one. You should be very cautious where to apply this formula, okay, where to find the velocity and where to find the speed. So you should know the parameters. You should be capable of extracting the data from the question and applying the correct parameters in the formulas. Okay, so always, my hint is always read the formulas minimum of 2 to 3 times. Then you write the given data. If you are very perfect in writing the given data, then you are very capable of completing the problem as soon as possible. Okay, then you know for which problem which formula is applicable. So you should be very capable of reading the problem and finding what is asked. So you first write what is a given data, then you go for the formula. Okay, so you first be clear in this basic formulas, then we move on to the next problem. Next one is, a cyclist starts from center O of a circular park of radius 1 kilometer, reaches H peak of the park, then cycles around the circle fronts and returns to the center along QO. So it will be useful when I draw it as a diagram to consider this diagram. So this is the center of a park, okay, this is a circular park, okay, the radius is 1 kilometer, okay, the radius of the park is 1 kilometer, then the cyclist is starting from here, moving to the circular orbit of the park at point P. And he is again moving in the circumference until the point Q. Okay, he is moving along the circumference and returns to the center along the point QO as given. So this is the figure given for this problem. If the round trip takes 10 minutes, the given time is, the time taken is 10 minutes, radius OP equal to 1 kilometer, okay, also QO equal to 1 kilometer, so both are same. Now what we have to form? What is the net displacement? Next one is average velocity and average speed of the cyclist. So when you talk about the displacement, it is a vector quantity. It has both direction and magnitude. The hint here is, a cyclist starts from point O. Consider the cyclist starts from point O and he is moving to point P, then P to Q and again Q to O. So the concept here is, when the net displacement, the starting point and ending point are same, the net displacement is zero. That is the hint here. The hint here is, when the starting and ending point are, starting and end point are same the net displacement is zero. Okay, so when the starting and end point are same, the net displacement is zero. So here what we have to find, the net displacement, so the average velocity. So average velocity is what? Net displacement by time taken. So average velocity, the first one is average velocity, which is net displacement. Divided by time taken. So here the, since the net displacement is zero, that is zero, so the average velocity is 0 meter per second. Next one is B. What is that? Average speed of the cyclist. Average speed of the cyclist. So what is the path? What is the path traveled by the? Here it is not a speed. Means speed is a scalar quantity. It is not a vector. So I am not relating the displacement here. I am just talking about the speed. So since it is a speed, we have to find a scalar quantity. That is the magnitude of the displacement. So OP, PQ and QO. Okay. The path is, path travel is OP plus PQ plus QO. So it's obvious that OP is 1 kilometer and QO is 1 kilometer. Then PQ is what? This is the circumference, outer circumference of the circle. And here for this, it is 1 quadrant only. For this, this is 1 quadrant. For circle, we have 4 quadrants. So this is totally 2 pi r. And this is 1/4 of the circumference. This what is 1/4 of circumference. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this part is 1/4 of the circumference. So that we can write as PQ is, so this is 1 plus 1 by 4, 2 pi r is, the radius is 1, so 2 into 22 by 7 into r plus 1. So 1 is 2 11, 1 plus, so it is 2 plus, what I get? The answer I get here is 25 by 7. 25 by 7 kilometer. So here the path length I get is 25. The path travel is 25 by 7 kilometers. That is the value. Then the time taken. So what is the time they have here? What is the speed they have? Speed equal to path divided by time. So the speed is path divided by time. So the time is already given, that is 10 minutes. We have to convert it into hours. So meter per second, that is path is 25 by 7 divided by, what is minutes? 10 by 60. So So the tally is you convert the minutes into hours, 1/6 hours. Okay. 1/6 hours. So the speed is 10 minutes. When I convert it into hours, that is 1/6 hours. The speed value I get is 21.43 kilometer per hour. So I will revise it in the average velocity. It is a net displacement by time. Since the starting and the ending point are same, the net displacement is zero, so the average velocity is always zero. Then the path traveled is OP plus PQ plus QO. That is, OP is 1 and QO is 1. PQ is the circumference. The circumference is 2 pi r, and this is only one quadrant we have traveled. So after solving, we get 25/7. The speed is path divided by time. The time is given in 10 minutes. That is 1/6 of an hour. So the speed is path divided by time, and get 21.43 kilometer per hour. Make a copy of the solution, students. Try to solve this problem on your own. And revise the book type problem, students. It will be very easy if you solve it on your own. Please apply the formulas what you have learned in the theory. Welcome, students. In this session, I am going to discuss about some problems based on the motion in a plane. Okay? So the first problem is, a particle starts from origin at t equal to 0 with a velocity of 5i meter per second. The given data is, the particle is moving in a plane. It's a two-dimension. So the velocity is given as phi I, that is the unit vector along the x-axis, and moves in the xy plane under the action of force. So initially it is moving in x-axis, and due to the action of force, the particle is moving in xy plane. The force given is to the particle, and the acceleration given is mentioned by 3i plus 2j meter per second square. This is the acceleration. So what is here? Find y coordinate at the instant when x is 84 meters. So we have to find the y coordinate of the particle when x is 84 meters, because when there is a force on the particle moves to the plane, that is a two dimensional motion. Then what is the particle? Then what is the question asked? What is the speed of the particle? That is, what is the speed? We have to find the speed of the particle. Okay. So the solution here, the given data is, so the formula. So what the formula that relates the displacement, the velocity and the acceleration, that is r. So r equal to v naught t plus half a t square. This is the formula that predicts the displacement, velocity and acceleration. So initially what is the velocity? That is, the velocity is along the one dimension, that is 5i. Okay, so here v naught is 5i. So I can replace, so this v naught everything is a function of time. Everything is a function of time. So R equals to 5i t plus of what is the acceleration? Given 3i plus 2j. 3i plus 2j times v square. Okay. Now, so R equals. Now I split the unit vectors. I split the equation by unit vectors. Okay, because I have I vector and j vector. I split the unit vectors separately. That is 5i t plus 3/2 I t square plus 1/2 j cap t square. So R is 5 plus 3/2 10, 13/2 into, and I'm sorry, this is not 13/2. Now take 5 t plus 3/2 t square into I cap plus 1/2 t square j cap. So this is the R vector. This is the R vector now. Okay? Then what we have to find? We have to find the value of this. So in that question we have asked, find the y coordinate at the instant when x equal to 84. So when x equal to 84, what is the value of y coordinate? So x equal to, given x equal to 84 meters. So we have to find the y value. Clear? Now, and we don't know the time. Clear? What is the time when x equal to 84? So you substitute the value of, so what is x coordinate here? X coordinate is 5t plus 3/2 t square. That is, this is x and this is y. So in general the formula for R is xi plus yj. So you consider this part as x and consider this part as y. Clear? When I differentiate the displacement, when I differentiate the displacement with respect to time, that is speed is dr by dt, I will get the speed. So what is this? Phi t will become phi plus, this will become 3t square, 3 by 2 into 2t into I. Plus, again I have the coordinate yt is t square. When I multiply t, differentiate t square, the value is 2t. 2t u g. So, you should be very clear in differentiating the simple formula. Okay, you should know the simple differentiation formula. So, at t equal to 6 seconds, the answer you get is 23.23i plus, what is the answer you get? 12j. So this is a vector. To find the magnitude, we have to take the square root of it, magnitude. So when I take the magnitude, I get v equal to square root of 23 square plus 12 square. Then the answer is 26 meter per second. 26 meter per second. And this is the final answer. So, I will tell the procedure of this sum. So, in this sum, it has been asked that we have to find the velocity. For that velocity, we need the displacement equation. When I differentiate the displacement with respect to time, I will get the velocity. So, the displacement is already being given in the question in the form of x and y separately. So, I have to consolidate both x and y terms. So the basic equation is x equal to v naught t plus half a t square. V naught is given, the t is an unknown, and half a is the acceleration that is already given in the question. R, then r is a displacement here. So when I substitute everything, I split the values as x and y coordinates separately. Then next I move on to the finding the time for 84. By substituting the value of x equal to 84, I find the time t equal to 6 again. Then finally the velocity, the speed, that is 26 meter per second. So the first answer is this one, the second one is this one. So write the formula separately, students. And another problem is, after finding t equal to 6, what is the value of y? Because value of y is y equal to t square here. So y equal to t square. So that is t is 6, so 6 square is 36, the value of y is 36, it should be written in meter, that is unit you should return.
A track
that turns to this left by an angle so 60 degree after every 500 meters. So then, starting from given turn, what we have to find is from the given turn, find the displacement at the 6th and 8th turns. So it's quite a different problem. So on an open ground, a motorist follows a track that turns to his left by an angle 60 degree after every 500 meters. So from given turn, find the displacement at 3rd, 6th, and 8th turn. So let us see by a diagram. Only if we convert the theory into a diagram, we can easily resolve the problems. Clear? Now compare the magnitude of displacement with total torque. That's the next one. I'll finally tell. So let's convert the theory into a diagram first. So what is being given? So I'll start the motorist at a point here. Let this motorist stop here. Okay, let this be a point where the motorist starts riding. So this is 500 meters. After this, it turns to an angle 60 degree. So this is 500 meters. Again, it turns to an angle 60 degree. Then again, what happens is he turns to an angle. So this is 60. 60. And again, 500 meters. The angle for each and every 500 meters, he is turning 60 degrees. Regular hexagon mathematically, this AO equals to OD. So which is 500 plus 500. So AD equals to 1000 meters. AD is 1000 meters. Next one is, what is being asked? The distance to the sixth letter. 3, 4, 5, 6. So at the sixth letter, what is the thing? The starting and the ending point meet each other. At the sixth displacement, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At the sixth letter, the motorist comes to the same point, A. So the displacement at the sixth turn is 0. So the displacement at turn 6 is 0, because the initial and final displacement are meeting. Okay, the initial and final points are meeting. So that's the logic behind this. That is, the starting point and ending points are same, or the initial point and the ending point are same for a displacement, then the displacement value is 0. Next, what is the thing? Ask the 8th term. What is the displacement for the 8th term? Where is the 8th term? 6. After 6, we are again is going 7 and 8. That is at point C. Here, that is, this is a AC. That is, you consider this A, B and C. We have to find the value AC. The third question is that displacement will be displacement AC. So for this we have to apply some formulas that is previously learned. So the formula here is the displacement of the motor is, that is AC. So since this is a triangle, this is a triangle. Okay? So we can apply the triangle law of vector addition. So it means AB is a vector, from BC this is a vector. Then AC is, we can use the triangle law of vector. So the angle between these two, AB and BC, is here we have 60 degrees. This angle, we can make this up here. This is here. So this, I have written it separately. I have drawn this diagram separately. A, B and C. I can apply the triangle law. So, I want to find this value. Clear? So, AC equals to square root of AB square plus AC square plus 2AB AC cos 60. That is the formula. That is BC. So apply this triangle law and make use of this formula that is previously learned. So AC is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2AB BC cos 60. So substitute the values 500 square plus 500 square plus 2 times 500 into cos 60, that is 1/2. So the answer I get is 866 meters. So substituting values and I get the value is 866. The inclination angle. Then finally, what is the inclination angle? How far this AC is inclined with AB? That we can use the law of sines. So AB is inclined, that is the formula tan beta equals to 500 sine 60 divided by 500 plus 500 cos 60. So this is the formula. So beta equal to 30 degrees. So for this we need to know that triangle law of vectors. Okay, so remember the angle formula and the magnitude formula very clearly. Any doubts, students, if you have, please make a note of it. Never forget to take the square root. You bring it everything inside the square root. And you can use either of the formulas for finding the angles.